everybody, it's Caressa, and we're back with our new coloring book, Bold and Easy Spring Scenes. Here's an example of one of the fall scenes I was talking about. It's clearly not a spring scene, I wouldn't say. But I thought today, I thought we could color this with some Ponky pencils. These, if you're interested in like Uni products, like as in the people who make Posca, they make these. These are kind of like if crayons and pencils had a baby, sort of. They're an interesting art supply. But yeah, they're the same people who make Posca stuff, so let's color with these today. This doesn't come with it. I use this to blend sometimes with it, but it's a blender pencil. But you get this and this. This is a sharpener in this very spiffy case. So let's go ahead and start. I'm thinking I'm gonna start with this pumpkin here. I'm gonna make it orange. I know, groundbreaking. So I'm gonna pick up the red. Yeah, the red and the brown and the orange. I'm gonna start with the red and make a shaded area. I'm trying to round out the shape. Come in with our brown. It's just gonna be our darkest dark. I'm gonna put it in here. Trying to follow the curve of the pumpkin, so like this. Let me pop on over here. Pick out the yellow and the peach. Actually, no, I don't want the peach. Change my mind. The peach. Get the yellow. Start burnishing the color a little bit. Would be. finishing. More dark areas. To sharpen this green. Get back in with my brown and burnish it. Sorry if I'm jiggling the camera. Sorry, I gotta move some stuff around here. Oh, my arm's getting tired already. Sorry. Now let's come in and pick colors for this pumpkin. Actually, I made a boo-boo. This isn't shadow. This is actually just the way the pumpkin is, so I'm gonna have to even this out a little bit. This is just, you know, the pumpkin is actually green and yellow, if that makes sense. So up here's the yellow. Thank you. books. Let us use this green again. This is gonna be our shadow. This green color, this dark green. We're gonna burnish it in. Need to sharpen this green up. Anyway, you can see what I mean. We're trying to follow the curve of the pumpkin, so making it nice and round. Okay. Come back with our yellow again. Burnish in a second layer. This layer with the lighter green. I somehow got a little orange right there, but I got a plan. I want to show you. Don't worry about it. Sorry if I'm jiggling. Striations. Have you ever seen cords that do this? I have. My area, I come from the Ozarks, and so in the fall there's always lots of pumpkins and cords and such hanging around. There we go. I like that. Okay, let's look at... I was just sitting there thinking, is that a leaf? That's a lemon. Okay, so let's look at the lemons, okay? Obviously, we're gonna need yellow. And I'm thinking orange. Maybe a little bit of brown for the darkest. Maybe a little, just a little. Okay. First, I'll start with the orange to mark out where my darkest is. And to make it textured, I'm gonna kinda do circles like this. Like that. Like this. On this lemon too. Okay. Yellow, do the same thing. Circles. Okay. Now come in with the brown. The brown, just a little bit at the bottom. Little bit. And now I'm gonna come in with the yellow. I'm gonna burnish the whole thing. Burnish, I mean pressing hard. Just working that color into the paper. Like that. texture going from the orange and the brown. Okay, and for the inside of the lemon, I'm just gonna press hard and do a little bit like this. Yeah, just like that. And just gently kind of go over the outside for the pith and all that. There we go. A little bit of orange just in the center. Done. Okay, now while I got this brown out, let's look at this cinnamon stick and this anise here. Let's go ahead and I'm gonna put this in here with moderate pressure. Same with this. Is that they will layer over each other really well. You don't have to worry about waxy buildup a lot. Okay, we got that apple for the apple. I'm going to use red, which is revolutionary, honestly. Burnishing again. Red. Right there where the stem comes out. Okay. And then I think I'll blend a little more green out here. Just a little bit. There. Okay. Is the apple done? Let's do the leaf of the apple real quick. But first, I really, really, really need to sharpen. Sorry, I'm reaching around. I'm using the cap off my other pencil. I'm gonna have to sharpen this green pencil real quick. So enjoy the ASMR of that. I will say one thing about sharpening these things. The shavings get everywhere and they like to stick. So, that's kind of a bummer. Okay. it must be done. It must. Okay, that's good enough for the green. I also need to sharpen this one a little bit. Enjoy the ASMR there. Just burnishing on that. Let's see, now I have to look at some of these leaves and make a decision on which ones are green and what color to make them and stuff. This one I think will be green, and I think that one will be green. Just kind of, I don't know. Just feel like it should be. Thanks again to everybody who's been subscribing and thumbing up my videos. Which one should I? I don't feel like both of them need to be. I think I'm gonna make this one green so it adds some interest to and contrast to all this brown and orange over here. Because this walnut's gonna be brown. Anyway, I wanted to say thank you to all the people who have been so awesome at thumbing up and viewing my videos and subscribing and stuff. You guys have made my day, seriously. Thank you so much. I just felt the need to shout that out. Some shout outs. I'm actually pressing pretty hard here because I want to burnish the color in. Making sure you can see what I'm doing. I like the way that this is coming out. Like I said, these Ponky pencils, and yes, they are called Ponky pencils, are a really fun medium to use. Okay, let me bring our pencils back. And we're gonna have to do the walnuts and the twigs. So brown, orange. I'm also gonna use a little black for the twigs. Start with the walnuts first. Oh, look at these shavings. I'm telling you, they get everywhere. See, for the walnut's gonna be mostly brown. I'm gonna shade it like this for a start. Like that. And then the lighter part can be peach. Preserve that space. And then maybe some orange in here. Just a little bit to give it some pizzazz. And then back with the brown. For my darkest areas. I'm just gonna kind of scribble that in a little bit to give it some texture. Alright. Now let's look at the twigs. The same with the stems. I'm gonna do a little bit of black here. Just a little bit. Just to add some depth. Okay. Same here. And then I'm going to come in with some orange in the lighter parts. Presence in my heart here. And then burnish. finish with the brown all the way down. So, just burnishing the black and the brown together and leaving the orange parts like this. To green. Like so. It's red. And orange. Sorry if that loud thunk you just heard scared you. My cat just jumped off of something. I don't know if you heard that or not, actually. Scared me anyway. Okay. With a little bit of red for shading, just go over the top like this. So I'm saying these do layer up really good. That's one of the benefits to them. One of the real problems I run into with these, though, is that there's a limited, like, I wish they made way more colors, because I would totally buy them all. Adding some interest, I think. Just like that. And over here, a little bit of green. And then we'll come up here and we'll shade with some brown. Pressing hard and then feathering out to nothing. Like this. Think. Let me put the pencils up here. give me a thumbs up, subscribe, drop a comment, say hi, okay? And thanks for joining me this time. I hope you'll join me next time, okay?